Greetings and salutations. Welcome to this, the third in my video playthrough of Fallout 4. Last time, we went up to the robot recycling center, and we found a sentry bot, which we activated and sent down here to the Olivia satellite station. That was it down there. It's coming back now. It was engaged in combat and then stopped and started heading back, so maybe it's through. Anyway, the purpose of this part of the walkthrough is to get some material and some equipment that we'll need in order to successfully do the Concord quest that's been assigned. And in order to do that, we need a couple of pieces of equipment. We got the Fat Man up at the recycling center, the robot recycling center, and we got a mini nuke. We're gonna try to pick up a mini nuke here at Olivia, but I'm at a level 2, so I have to be very careful as to what kind of fights and scrapes I get into, and so that's the reason why we activated the robot, sent him down here. So he's clearing out at least the outside of the satellite center, so that I can go inside and find the stuff that I do want. We'll hide down here. This is the first time I've actually activated this robot, and so I don't know if he'll treat me as a friendly or as a foe, so that's the reason why I'm kind of hiding from him. He's inside the shed. Guess he's just doing a sweep of everything that he can get a hold of. He is ignoring me, so I guess that he's going to consider me a friend, but I'll still stay out of his way. Do some scavenging while I'm waiting. Like he found a mole rat. So we'll scavenge that. I don't know what he meant by he suggested repairs to his primary systems. I don't know if he's damaged during that combat or what. That's not good. He keeps running into the rocks. So maybe I ought to shut him down. He's not going anywhere. The program said that I could send him over to Revere Satellite System, but it's got a bunch of super mutants and a couple of suiciders, and so they'd probably take him out, and I'd not be able to scavenge from him. So, I could also send him down to South Boston, but there's nothing down there that he would protect, so I'm going to do a self-destruct. The reason why is he has a couple of fusion cores that I want. So, yes. Self-destruct so that I can take your stuff. Yeah, I want to get out of the way because when he blows up, I definitely don't want to be anywhere near it. So I'll run up here and do some scavenging while he self-destructs. And there he goes. He's done a very good job of clearing this. There were several mole rats. One of them had a bomb connected. And a couple of raiders. So he cleared all them. Usually there are a couple of bloatflies involved too. But I don't see them anywhere. So maybe they're not in this playthrough. But anyway, still scavenging. And we'll run down to where he is and get those fusion cores. I always check things to make sure that I did get them, even though I've scavenged from them before. And there's two fusion cores. We'll pick those up, plus everything else. And we're done with the outside. Now we want to get inside, and there are three things in there that I want to get. And I'll show them to you when we get down there. Two of them are behind a locked door, so we're going to have to go find the key for it. All right, we're in the door and heading down the steps. There's going to be a tripwire down here, so we'll deactivate it and then deactivate the Tesla arc. Make sure you do that when you play, so that way you get the fusion cells or the fuel cells. On this top level, there are two raiders and one dog. So we just took that one out. You'll see the two red dots on my target at the bottom. Those are the other two reacting. You can hear the dog running. I should have aimed for his head, because that's what would have happened. So two down, one to go.
Done this hundreds of times. Think you'll be any different?
And that clears the raiders at the top level. And now I'm over encumbered. Not a good way to be if I've got to do a fight. And I've still got several raiders to go. So we'll go to this locker. We'll dump some of the stuff that I'm carrying that I don't need. And we're not going to get rid of it permanently. We're just going to put it here for right now so that I can go do the fight. Okay, check the inventory, see what I do have. I have some frag grenades, so we'll arm those just in case I need them. See if she has anything I need that I can't do without, and she doesn't, so on down we go. Total of five down here on this level. We just saw one. There are four around the corner. Headshot. Nice. Problem with that is that wakes the others up. Here they come. One of them is a strong boss and has a minigun, which makes her a little harder to kill. There she is in the super background. And she starts shooting at me. Evidently, one of the raiders stepped in front of her. Nothing I can do about that, but we'll go around the corner now while they're trying to chase me through that hallway. And axe down, which is good. Now, I grab the mini because if I don't, and there's a survivor, they tend to grab it, and then I gotta kill somebody with a minigun again. So I grab it just as quickly as I can. So now that makes five dead down here. That's everybody. I do have some low health, so take a stim pack or two and drink some water. That brings me back to full health. I'm going to sweep the place just to make sure that there aren't any more people. Sometimes there's an extra one. So I just want to make sure. That seems to be all of them here. Grab the locket. That's for something else we'll use a little later. Steal all the junk I can get. Time to pick the lock.
Got it.
And there we go. There are five red roaches in here, I believe, maybe six. That one's big. Yeah, that one crawled behind the door, so didn't hit. Three down. I keep hitting the wrong key. Q and tab are right next to each other. Four down. Two more out there. Go and scavenge the red roach meat. And there's a fifth one crawling around. And that's the end of that one. Now, what we really want is back here in this corner, but we have another red roach to deal with as he comes out from underneath the body. And that's it for him. That's all six red roaches down here. Now, what I want in there is the key to my intel room. And that's a room we passed by upstairs. I didn't check the door because I knew I couldn't get in. That multicolored glisteny stuff is oil. And in some cases, whenever I shoot these rad roaches, those things catch, that catches on fire, catches all of them on fire, and catches me on fire. So I have to be very careful whenever I shoot in that room. We'll probably come back here again in the future. Which case, probably that thing will catch on fire and you'll see what I'm talking about. Going and scavenging everything I can get, and it's going to over-encumber me, but that's okay. So, that's everybody down here. The only thing left down here that I really want is the fusion core from the generator. So we'll just go over there and get that guy. And then make our way upstairs. Okay, and on the way out, we'll stop and scavenge from the raiders that we didn't get everything from. Because if I'm going to be over-encumbered, I might as well be totally over-encumbered. We're going over to the intel room here. Use the key we got downstairs, and guess what's there? A mini nuke. There's also the camouflage magazine, so I grab that. It'll help in sneak and ninja. Sweet. Empty out the safe. There's a chest back there with some ammunition and other stuff. Get the Nuka-Cola. Check to see if there's anything on the desks. Pre-war money's always good. Take that fan. I don't know why I left the other fan. Always likes taking fans. Now we're going back to the locker to get the stuff that I left behind. For some reason, it re-equipped my baton. I'll fix that in a moment. The other thing is, anytime I get a chance to get oil, I will. Oil and gears seem to be always in demand. So that's everything down here. We'll start working our way upstairs. Now, I know that this will be slow, but I have found in the past that it really takes just about as much time to dump the extra weight and then come back and get it and make two trips as it does to make the walk back. Even with fast travel, it takes about as much time. So I don't do it too often, but in this case, it actually is better to trudge along over-encumbered. But I may not be over-encumbered long. Back over here towards the robot recycling center, there's a wrecked vertibird. And beside the wrecked vertibird is always a set of power armor. Now, it's not a complete set, but it does have the frame, And if you load up the frame, that does tend to make carrying things a lot easier. So maybe after we pick up the power armor, I won't be over encumbered anymore. We'll wait and see. It's a little bit out of the way, but it's still worth it to pick up the power armor and then whatever stuff is in the boxes that surround the vertebrate. Yeah, the wooden crate only has some red X. Usually has more. Oh well. Such are the fortunes of the random generator. Up in here, in the pilot seat, there is a helmet. You've got to get all the way into the vertebrate to get it. And there's the power armor. I'm not willing to fight these red stags, so I'll just wait them out. Generally, if you don't run at them, they'll run away. And there's my power armor. Only has a helmet, right arm, and torso, but it's enough with the frame. Power it up and enter. Alright, looks good. Ah, still 27 pounds over. Wow. Oh well. We'll just walk home. It'll be alright. Making sure that red stag doesn't attack from behind. And so we're good. We head towards the road. And we won't walk all the way by road. We'll just go down this road a little bit until we can turn right. And then we'll head back through the forest, back to Sanctuary. So, review. We picked up some caps at the lifting station, where the water pump sealed the machine and the caps were inside. So, by turning the pump off and opening that door, we were able to get the caps. There was a snub nose 44 there with ammunition. There were some chems there that we needed. We killed three raiders there, and that gave us some stim packs and some various other things. We went to the little campsite at the top of the hill, and we got some ammo and some chems there. Killed a raider and a dog at that point. Then we went over to the robot recycling center where we found the sentry bot. We activated him and he killed a bunch of mole rats there at the recycling center. And we sent him down to the satellite station Olivia. Also while we were there, we picked up a fusion core that was in one of the boxes. And we picked up a Fat Man and a mini nuke. Also, there was the Hot Rodder magazine, which gives us a paint scheme for our power armor, as well as some chems and equipment inside the shack. Here we had some ammo and some caps inside that safe, and it's always there by the abandoned shack or collapsed shack, and the only thing that's left standing is the chimney. This is the campsite where we killed the three raiders. So all's good there. And we just keep walking this way. Up to our right is going to be the lifting station where we got the caps and the 44. Behind this tree, I believe, is our raider that we killed. And so we just keep heading this way, and it'll take us to the Red Rocket. Now, some of you may be asking me why I haven't picked up Dog Meat yet and used him as we carry around. The reason why I don't use Dog Meat or many companions is because I find that they get in the way of a stealth build. They don't know how to sneak, even though when you go into sneak mode, they crouch. They talk, they make a lot of noise, they distract. And they just don't really know how to be stealthy. And so I find that they get in the way more than anything else. And so in my sniper build, I don't use the companions that much. We will pick up dog meat a little bit later, and we'll just take him to Sanctuary and let him stay with Marcy. I figure she deserves him. So you can see Sanctuary to our right over there. You can see the lake. Things are going well. Making good time across this little forest, wooded area, whatever you want to call it. I play a conservative game. I don't like dying. It frustrates me, and that was one of my problems with video games before, is that I just never could win. This way I can stay alive and proceed through the quest and play the game, and it becomes enjoyable to me. I will admit the first few times that I played, I had to play in God mode. Otherwise, I would have died so often that it would have been frustrating, and I quit. And so, God mode made this entertaining for me. It allowed me to go through a couple of plays, learn the things that would keep me alive. And it's what made the game enjoyable to me. Wonder where those rads came from. I've been down this trail many times, and I've never picked up rads, so I don't know where those came from. All right, we're at the bridge, up and over. If you remember, we're carrying something like 347, I'm going to call them pounds, you can call them kilos, you can call them whatever you want, 347 is the unit. With the power armor, I'm able to clear 320, so I'm 27 pounds overweight, which isn't too bad. Like I say, it didn't cost too much time to get here. I tend to not use fast travel that much in the early parts of the game, simply because that gives me a sense of distance and space in the game, and I enjoy that. Later on, after I get leveled up quite a bit, I'll start fast tracking when there are more places to fast track to. All right, we're here. So I run into the wall because I forget which key to push. We're going to exit the power armor. Take my fusion core back. And put the power armor in the craft station. Just to make sure that everything's okay and that nothing needs to be repaired. It's all okay, and so I leave it. Next is to go over to the workstation and get rid of all of my junk. What we're going to do is, because we're going to do Concord, I want to carry as little as possible into Concord. So I'm going to get rid of everything that I don't need for Concord. So we'll keep the pistol, the fat man. Won't take the minigun. The reason why is going to be obvious when we get there. Get rid of everything else. Keep the pipe rifle, simply because right now seems to be the most deadly, most accurate I've got. And we'll keep the snub nose just in case I need some power to shoot something. I'm trying to decide right now whether to keep the Drifter outfit or to change over to the leather. And I've decided to change to the leather. So we'll get rid of everything but one of each. Probably will use the Raider leather as my base. But then I see I have road leathers, so we'll get rid of the Raider leathers and just use the road leathers. I know you don't care, but just sharing you with you my mindset. We'll get rid of everything that I'm carrying as far as food and aid. The only thing that I'll want is those things that will heal me, and then maybe some other drugs. I'll keep the jet, the Med-X, the Mentats. Get rid of the food. Keep the purified water to the Rad-X right away. Get rid of the roach meat and the salt bean. Keep the stem pack. Get rid of the thistle and the wild mutt fruit. Don't need the holotape anymore. We'll just get rid of all of this. Can't get rid of the locket because it's going to be quest related, so get rid of the junk. Hit the wrong key. Junk's gone. Ammo doesn't weigh anything, so we'll just keep it. Okay, time to put the leather on. So the first thing we'll do is put the road leathers and then put each one of the pieces of leather armor on. Get rid of the Drifter outfit. That gets me down to 60 pounds. I noticed that I had a wedding ring. I don't need to carry it into battle. Nora's wedding ring. I'll keep mine for right now. Now I'm going over to the armorer station to see if I can put some additions into the leather that I'm carrying. I don't really want a increase in protection, but I do want an increase in carry. So I try to pocket it. And so we pocketed the chest. We'll see if we can do one of the arms. And I don't have enough adhesive for that. So we now must search for adhesive so that we can create pocketed leather. That pretty much still takes care of where I'm at right now. We'll check the weapon station to see if there's anything I can do to the gun. I don't think there is. I don't have the gun nut yet. And I don't have any pre-made mods. So, no. There's nothing I can do to this. It's worth a look, though. Okay, I was going to save and then shut down, but then I remembered that I had not picked up the grognak or the special book in the house, and so real quickly we'll run over and pick that up so that we can get that percentage, and we'll pick up the special, and as a part of the sharpshooter sniper build from Fudge Muppet, we will put that in luck, which is a part of their build. So, that takes care of that. Double check my inventory, make sure that I've got everything out of the way. Get rid of Grognak and the special book now that I've got the perks for them. Make sure there's nothing that I really want. And there isn't. And so now I'll do the save and then we'll shut down. And that'll be the end of this one. So thanks for watching, and we'll pick it up next time when we actually do the Concord.